In this video, we're going to answer the question, can I run cables in the cavity of an external wall? This question relates to the video Gary and Gordon made on the super adaptable Elemento range of outdoor accessories from Hamilton Lightstat, an innovative range where you can pretty much create your own IP66 rated accessory. It's a neat innovation and one worth investigating, so check that video out if you haven't already seen it. However, when we're getting cables from the inside to the outside for any kind of electrical item, it can be quite tempting to run that cable inside that massive cable channel that the builders have kindly created for us when constructing the house in the form of the cavity between the outer and inner leaves of the walls. Now, there's no specific regulation that states you absolutely mustn't do this. However, there are a few things to consider from both an electrical and also a construction point of view. If the cable is running a significant distance in the cavity, then it won't be supported with clips, cleats, or similar, meaning that it may be damaged by its own weight. The cavity generally serves two purposes, the first of which is that it creates an insulating layer. Even if it's left as an air void, it will still serve this purpose. Often, however, the cavity is filled with a layer of thermally insulating material. If this is fiberglass or similar, you've got the problem that the cable is surrounded by insulation, and this seriously impacts on its current carrying capacity, meaning that it may not be compliant with the regs. If the insulation is made of polystyrene, not only have you got the derating issue, but also a PVC cable laying in contact with polystyrene will start to degrade over time as the two materials react with each other, and the cable will appear to eat into the polystyrene, causing both materials to underperform. But what about that construction issue? Well, Part C of the building reg stipulates that the cavity is to be bridged only by wall ties, cavity trays and cavity barriers, fire stops and cavity closures where appropriate. This is to ensure the cavity performs its other function of preventing the transfer of moisture from the outside world to the inside of the property. If your cable makes physical contact between the two leaves of the wall, it can transfer moisture into the property, causing damp and mold to form. In addition to this, the metal cable ties bridging the cavity can also damage the cable during installation. So there we go. The simple answer to this question is no, you shouldn't run cables in the cavity of an external wall for the reasons that we've just considered. Interestingly though, the NIC EIC have published guidance suggesting that a designer may consider a sheathed mineral insulated copper sheathed cable to be an acceptable solution if a cable must be installed in a cavity. However, as always, we want to hear from you. Do you see running cables in a cavity to be a problem? Will you be rethinking the way you run cables based on this information? Whatever your thoughts and questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.